the significance? How do you feel after unveiling the statue of your grandfather? What are the feelings that you're going through at the moment?
Yeah, I mean, it's a great honor. I didn't know about it until about a month and a half ago when I was first invited, so I didn't know that this was in the planning. But I'm very pleased to be here. I knew that Lumbini was an important place for my grandfather. I'd read in his books, and I know from my own family. We had visited once in 1982 when I was a child, so I knew it was a special place for him and for my family. And of course, it's a great pleasure to be here for the unveiling of this statue, which I hope just symbolizes, it's a way of recognizing his link to this place, but I hope it symbolizes a commitment by many people to continue in the development of this sacred site.
And how would you like the message of Lumbini to be spread? What kind of place do you want Lumbini to be seen as? Because your grandfather had a vision
for
this place.
Sure. I mean, first, it's simply to mark the birthplace of the Buddha, to make this a place where Buddhist pilgrims can come from all over the world. And it's already that, but that can continue and expand in the years to come. But secondly, I think it's about making this a genuinely beautiful place, remaking it in a way that would be attractive to people, not just Buddhists, from all over the world, to make this a place, a peaceful, tranquil place. I think the thing that struck Uthan when he came was the peacefulness and the sanctity of the location. And I think he had in his mind that if it was developed in the right way, that this would be an incredibly special place internationally as well. So I think if it can go forward on that path, so it's not just about the religion, but linking it as a sacred site to international efforts on a whole range of issues, I think that would be a very good thing if it was possible.
Any fond memories from your last trip back in 82 when you were young?
Yeah, 82. I don't remember very well. I mean, Kathmandu was a small place then at that time. I remember we stayed there. We drove with some Buddhist nuns from Myanmar, from Burma. It was a long car trip, and it was my first time as a child in Nepal. So I remember we stayed at the government guest house. We had a meal of, I think, mutton, and we made a donation to the local monastery, but that was about it.
And what kind of message would you like to take back to, let's say, your country,
yeah,
which have large Buddhist population?
Yes.
Do you think that we're doing things in the right way?
Yes. No, I think a couple of things. I think one is there's a huge interest, I think, in a growing middle class and better off people in Myanmar to explore the world. I think many people have this idea that they can go on Buddhist pilgrimage to India. They kind of come to Lumbini as an adjunct to that. I think it would be great if in the future they could come straight to Nepal as well, that many people visited not just Lumbini but also Kathmandu and other places in Nepal too. I think our two countries are different in many ways but similar in many ways. I think people from Myanmar would find this country fascinating. So I think to make Lumbini an anchor for their visit, but also a kind of a gateway to seeing the rest of Nepal as well.
I think that covers it.
Yeah, okay, thank you. Sure, thank you very much.